I'm trying to figure out what I'm doing here. Hey, it's James and JTC and Treats in DeSoto, Texas. I'm new to this, trying to FaceTime and all this kind of stuff. I'm lost. I couldn't put any pictures up of my rig and what I've been doing here. But I've been under cancer treatments for a couple of years now, and I'm getting over some stuff. And I'm trying to get out here. I've been building a lemonade stand. I've been watching out for Warren Russell, Jeff, and a couple other guys trying to get their lemonade Smisher Smasher, as Ben says, Smisher Smasher setup. So I've been working diligently trying to get this thing going. I'm just glad to finally get to be a part of this stuff here. And I don't know what I'm doing, so I wish I could put some pictures up there and let y'all see what I've been up to, you know. So I've been with the health department, the fire department, the city, the mayor, and you name it, trying to get this thing up and going. I sold scrap metal and everything else trying to get a trailer built, which is failing me. But I'm just trying to listen up and get educated some more. I got my Bible here. Y'all seen this Bible before? Can you see it? Yep, that's my Bible. And I've been living by that thing diligently. And Ben's always talking about his yellow pads. So I got not yellow pads, but these things here and this thing here and a whole bunch of other stuff down here trying to educate myself on trying to get this hot dog lemonade, breakfast biscuits. Man, there's a host of stuff I'm trying to do here, but I'm trying to get it together so I can support my income because I want a disability income trying to build myself up and help those children in the hospital with those cancers, you know, treatments. So I know how that is. They have that cancer and not being able to afford stuff. So I'm gonna let y'all finish talking so y'all can celebrate and host the show and talk to other vendors and see what we got going on. Maybe I can learn something else.
Well, howdy, howdy, howdy. I am glad to be here.
There he is.
I am and hope you are too. I'm excited for tonight. We've done two carts this year. One was secretly for a family, and then we did one publicly in our VU group. We gave one away. And we just did it random. One just random one of our we meet every Monday and Thursday at 9, and we just gave one away. I'm excited. I have read more emails. My eyes were bleeding. And thankfully I had Tasha to help me go through them because there was hundreds. And there was some that, you know, even though I said don't send me sob stories, and it's not that I downplay sob stories, we just all have one, and I'm a mushy heart. And so then I end up, you know, I'd have to go borrow $6 million to give all the cards away I want to give away, because it changes lives. It changed my life, and it's what inspired me to do this. I felt morally obligated. I said I got to do this, and I got to help people. And so in 2009, when I started teaching people, I it was nothing. It was just YouTube. You can go back to it and look at it. My first video ever. I was scared to death. I was shaking. I didn't know what to say, how to say it. But I was getting so many people asking me locally how to start. I just said, well, I'll just make one little YouTube video and tell them how to start. And I can just say, go to this YouTube. And back then I had the YouTube on the, you know, after a few videos that you can YouTube partner and they can throw up 85 commercials while you're listening to something. And that did well. And I said, you know what? I don't like commercials, and I'm sure everybody else doesn't like commercials. So, I'm still a YouTube partner, but if you notice on none of my videos, there is no ads. I don't do it. And I hate it. I hate the ads. They break my train of thought, and they're annoying. We've got a lot to cover tonight, but I'm going to do my best to keep up with it. I will answer questions at the end if you want, but I don't have this isn't going to take that much time other than just my jibber jabbery stuff. But I want to tell you, you're meeting inside where we meet twice a week, like I said earlier, Mondays and Thursdays at 9 p.m. It's not required, you know, but then we record it, and it's all vendors. Lyman Robertson, which is in here, he starts it at 8:30 and does a pre-show. And you've got people like Dean and Heather, and you've got Ken Packer, and all these people that come in and help one another. Doug's Dogs is in here tonight. His name is Michael Wood. You've probably seen his videos on my YouTube. He does a day in the life of a vendor series. And if you would, if you don't care, please mute for now. Just mute your mic. And that way it doesn't jump up if your dog, you know, bites your leg or six of your kids run in wanting Pop Tarts before bed. Anyway, I want to say this. I was listening to this little, you know, everybody talk during the beginning, and you were lit. I'm sure you heard a lot of the vendors talking. A lot of those are in Vendors United, but James Hicks stood out to me, and he's trying to get his lemonade stuff started. And James, this ain't part of tonight deal, but I'm going to send you a brand new Smasher. Cause I have some in a secret vault, with the, chopper thing, the whole works. I'm gonna send it all to you. All you have to do is email me Ben@vendorsunited.com and say, hey, this is James Hicks. Here's where to send it. And that's all you got to put. And I'll mail it to you and it's yours. Now let's see. I made myself notes just so I'd stay on track. Cause I am horrible about going off on a tangent and then I'll be on 16 stories, not finish one of them. And so I made myself notes. Some of you have emailed me and messaged me, especially VU members in the last little bit and said, hey, I didn't get my entry until just now. Is it too late? I didn't have it too late. I read an entry about 15 minutes ago that brought tears to my eyes. I had already opened this up and I read through it. Tasha read through it, brought tears to my eyes. And it wasn't a sob story. It was the way it was written. And you can feel this guy's passion. And I just wish I had more carts to give away or could afford to give away more carts. I can always build carts. I just can't build them and pay for them. So anyway, you'll see me stop every now and then. And what I'm doing is I've got some people in here that I want to share with you a little bit. And so Vendors United, we're just a group of vendors. There's vendors in there that are doing kettle corn and funnel cakes and elephant ears and boiled peanuts and lemonade and hot dogs. And we've got guys doing mashed potatoes. We've got guys doing soup carts. We've got guys doing barbecue and a coffee cart. You know, I interviewed that girl a while back that does coffee. And she started on the street and then ended up getting a gig at I'm not going to think of this. It's either Twitter or Google or one of those in the whatever California area where they do all that. Silicon Valley. That's it. Silicon Valley. She's there. She goes and does that. And she makes over 20 grand a month and they prepay it. So they prepay her to come in and serve coffee in the mornings from her little coffee cart. And when I say little coffee cart, it is beautiful. And hopefully you'll go look at that. You can go to learnhotdogs.com and you can just type in the word coffee and you're going to pull her up. So there's just so much you can do in this business. And there's even stuff that a lot of people go, well, I can't start. And going through the emails that I went through over the last few days is that a lot of people think, oh, I got to get a cart before I can start. And no, that's not true. There's so many other options. And you can go to cottagefoodlaws.com and figure out ways that's legal in all 50 states now. All 50 states have a cottage food similar law that allows you, even if you're in an apartment, to cook and prepare stuff that you can sell. And I have took me over a year to go through that, every state's codes, and put it down for you. It's free information. I put it out there for anybody in the world. And you don't have to sign up to get the information. You don't have to put in an email or nothing. Just get the information, cottagefoodlaws.com. You can start, even if you don't need it, maybe you're going to meet somebody that needs it. Maybe there's a single mom at church that's trying to figure out how to make ends meet and get kids to school and all that stuff. And all of a sudden she can make pound cake or sourdough bread from home and sell it legally without a permit and a license in most states. No permitting, no nothing. So a lot of it's covered by agriculture. So I explain all that there. It's a good way to get started. We talk about catering and drop-off catering in learnhotdogs.com and especially in Vendors United. All the ways, instead of being, most people think I get a cart and I'm going to be at 5th and Main. And that's where I'm going to be. I'm going to be in front of Walmart. I'm going to be in front of Home Depot or Lowe's. And that's what we think. But the truth is I made way more money doing it in a small town in front of a factory, something nobody ever saw me. I was there Tuesdays and Thursday nights from 11 p.m. to 1 a.m., just two nights a week. But those nights made me about $900. And that was gross income. But take away my costs and stuff, I'm still down to about $620. And I put it in my book, but my point is there's so many of these, I call them obscure locations that nobody thinks of, because I have people call me and go, Ben, I'm in Globe, Arizona. I ain't never seen a cart. Well, I have a lady there with four carts. She's kicking butt. And she was scared to death that the first cart, she wasn't even going to be able to make it. And she was willing to drive all the way to Flagstaff, just to be around more people. And now she's got four carts in Globe. Okay. Little bitty town. Mm-hmm. Then you got people like Jason Brown, and I don't know if Jason's made it in here tonight. I don't even know if he's going to come in here tonight. I wish he would, but Jason is in a town called Skip Back or Harley. Well, he's next to Skip Back. Harleysville, Pennsylvania. He's was a police officer, got hit by a DUI driver, got injured, started doing hot dogs, killed it. And if you've been around me long, you know who Jason is. He's very to the point, and he ticks off a lot of people because he has a lot of Yankee in him. And I'm nothing against Yankees, but they just speak their mind, and here's the way it is. And he this is a guy that was doing 300, 350 a year off one vehicle, one thing. So you go, holy cow, how do you do that? Well, and if you don't believe me, you can go watch his videos. I've filmed him multiple times. I've gone up to Pennsylvania and I've filmed him. I've worked with him at events. I didn't get to go to the one of the biggest things he did was the Beyonce and Jay-Z concert, but only for the staff, Beyonce, Jay-Z and their staff. And he did it in the back, and that was a gob of money. You know, you go surf, not that many meals and make $100,000. There's so many things that we teach in Vendors United about this and how to get there. And I could put all of this stuff out there on YouTube, and it's going to go mostly over most people's heads. And so we don't. I needed a place where a James Hicks or an Eric Sanchez or a Lyman Robertson felt comfortable sharing their problem they just ran into last weekend. And they'd be able to talk to vendors who cared and wanted to share and help each other. And there's no judgment. It's a judgment-free zone. We don't talk politics. We don't talk religion. We just talk love. We love one another, and we help one another, and we better ourselves. And you'll find that there's somebody in here tonight that's helping me moderate is Doug's Dogs. You'll see him on your screen. And that's Michael Wood. And this is a guy that is retired now from Vindy. And he's in a little bitty town in Georgia. And when I say little bitty town, where he lives, there's one blinky light. One blinky light. That's it. And Tosh and I went and saw him down there. And I've been down there multiple times over the years. But this guy is still in VU helping people every single day, 7 days a week. He just helps and answers questions and shows compassion and wants to steer you in the right direction. We don't mind if you're type A personality, because we probably all are, and because we're entrepreneurs and we want to do it our way. And then we go, crap, I've done 17 learning curves. If I'd have just listened to Jason Brown or Michael Wood, I would have had it. So there's a lot of benefit to be had from VU. And I would invite you to join. I would love it if you would join. And here's the biggest reason. When you join VU, the people that are in there are the most successful vendors I've ever met, got to know, love, know their families, go to funerals, go to weddings. VU is just an amazing place where you will get every bit of help you want 7 days a week, 24 hours a day. And it's where I spend most of my time with VU members. And all that stands for is Vendors United. You can go to vendorsunited.com. I'm going to do something, and I'll go ahead and tell you this real quick. I wasn't going to do this till towards the end, but I'm going to go ahead and tell you. VU costs $27 a month. You can try it for 5 days. It's not a limited trial where you can't see everything. You get to see and be a part of everything for the full 5 days. I've got courses on there that are free to members and stuff like that. You get it all free. You can go in there and grab a coupon and get something from our site and never come back. And I have people that do that. And I don't blame anybody, but what I'm saying is my goal is if I can get you there and you're serious about it and you want the change and you want to be the best you can be and have the most help and support along the way, that's where the best place is to me. But tonight I'm going to do this. It cost you, if you go to Taco Bell, and I know my VU members remember this, from about 2 months ago, Tosh and I went to Taco Bell. It's like a sin for us. And we go and we enjoy it. But we went and got, she got a meal, I got a meal, and we didn't only got one drink. So we didn't get a combo or anything. And it was $20-something. Okay. Well, today I looked up what it averages is for an average ticket at Taco Bell is $27. It's actually $27.84. But so let's call it $28. VU's $27 a month. So the cost of one trip to Taco Bell or the cost of a few trips down to Starbucks for a overpriced coffee, you can do VU and actually help your life. You don't have to join. It's not part of the deal tonight. I am giving away a cart in VU, and I'm giving away a cart to anyone. It could be anyone, whether they're VU or not. I didn't look up that stuff. All I did is had our VU members tell me if they send me basically an email if they could use this cart. The rest of everybody else went into one big grouping. So tonight, if you join this month at all, you get in, I don't care if it's a week from now, 2 weeks from now, you get in this month and you do the annual membership, which is $243. It saves you a little bit from over the, you know, saves you $60 or something, over doing it month to month. If you do the, or you switch your membership. So this applies to you too, the U members. I'm going to give you double your money back on a coupon at Hot Dog Cart Store on any cart, and that coupon will be good for a year. And if you need to extend it past that, I'll extend it. But my point is, I'm going to make it a year. So that's going to give you $486 back for spending $243. And if you join tonight, okay, I'm going to quadruple it. So I'm going to give you whatever the quadruple of $243 is. So $900 and something. I'm going to give you, I think that's close to $1,000, and I'm going to give you a coupon. I'll send those out automatically and I'll save them for you just so that I know who you are. If you came back 13 months from now and said, Ben, I'm ready to get a cart, I'm going to still honor that coupon. Now, I think that is most of that. If you have any questions, you can always email me. You can always try VU and ask questions in there, but I would love it. If my VU members, not my, but you know, my friends in VU, if you would raise your hand, if you're willing to give like a testimonial, just a short, you know, I don't care. It doesn't need to be a book. And just tell me what it means to you, why you're there, and what it's done. Tom, you're first. Thank you a ton. Go ahead.
Okay, guys. Yeah, I joined VU during 2022, and I started looking at how to get into the hot dog business. And, you know, one of the things that you find out is there's a process you have to go through. You can't just buy a cart and go. I mean, just this week, I saw a cart for sale here in my area, and I can look at the cart and tell that the health department would never approve that cart. So you've got to do your due diligence. And that's one of the things that they help us with here is being able to know what the processes are and then how to deal with some of the things. We share a lot of things with each other here. We share our praises, but we also share our pitfalls that we come across. Commissary location. Finding a commissary is so hard here, and it probably is for some of you new guys as well. And there's so much advice about where you can find that. Health department, sometimes you get a health inspector who doesn't know what they're doing. They don't know the code. It's good for you to know the code. And how do you deal with that when they're telling you you can't do something and you know something you can do? City officials who tell you you can't do something. We're all here to help you find your way through that process. So it has been nothing but invaluable. My wife had told me, she said, it's the best money you've ever spent is joining VU. And so got my cart last year in July when Ben had a sale. Being a VU member, Mafia member, saved a lot of money. And so that helped out. I got started in December part-time, retired from my job in April, and now this is what I do full-time and loving every minute of it.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. For that, I turned off my camera. Thank you so much for that. I appreciate it. Ken Packer, my good friend, Tennessee.
We are good friends, Ben. I'm very thankful for that. So I'm currently in Shawville, Virginia. I have a setup tonight. So if I have to drop the phone, you know, in fact, I just got a customer come up. Ben, can I come back to you?
Yeah, come on back.
Thanks, man.
Ken is so awesome. I got to tell you real quick. Ken won a cart. He built a cart. Then he won a cart. Later, he's been in VU a long, long time. He helps so many people, and he travels between Tennessee, Virginia, and Pennsylvania. His hometown is in Pennsylvania, and Tasha and I have been up there and watched him and videoed him, and he is maddening how good he does, and he does both, hot dogs and lemonade, but I can't wait for him to come back. All right, Renee, go ahead.
Yeah, hi, everybody. Hey, we just started in July, and I had like three nervous breakdowns. I'm telling you, it wasn't easy, right? We came across Ben's website at lemonade.com. I don't remember the exact site, but like the information was there. That was the inspiration, right? And then the emails that we got from Ben and like the way the courses are structured and the way the information is structured, it gave us the confidence to do it, right? To actually go out there and do it. And then we went on the Zoom call, had some questions, and Ben and both Ken answered those questions. They gave us the information we needed so we wouldn't overplan, right? And so, I mean, VU has been like, without VU, there's no way that we would be successful. We're very successful from the way we do our signage to the way we do our advertisements. All of the little details that are shared by Ben, I watch those videos on YouTube over and over again. Every time I watch that video, I learn something new. It's really about the details and just executing what is shared. Like we're fully 100% like doing that, right? Like listening to what is being said. These guys are the experts, and it's been great. Like we really like being part of the community. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for telling us how you feel, and we're glad you're here as well. Lyman, my dear friend Lyman, the one that runs the pre-show every Monday and Thursday night. Go ahead, Lyman.
Hey, guys. I'm glad to be here. I am out on an emergency camping trip with the family, and it's pouring down rain. I'm sitting out under the canopy of the camper. But hey, I've been vending for on and off for 22 years. I started out doing funnel cakes. I listened to Ben while I was driving a truck. I'm a retired truck driver now, and listened to Ben's videos, watched his videos and all. And like I said, I started out with funnel cakes and I wanted to incorporate hot dogs with it. So I got with my health department and talked with him, kept selling funnel cakes, got the money up and added some equipment into my trailer. And now I'm knocking it down with the hot dogs, bologna steak sandwiches, smoked sausages, you name it, I'll cook it. I'll go out every day vending, and it has really changed my life around and turned things around for me. Ben and the group here have been nothing but pure inspiration. There's never anything negative said. There's never, ever a dumb question asked. Believe me, I do the pre-show now. Ben has trusted me to do that. Any questions that's asked, we try to find an answer. If we don't, we'll make up an answer. And it's just a wonderful group. We help each other out. We don't cut each other's throats. We've got some guys in here that have friends in this group that live close together, and they'll get together and work at an event. So it's not a cutthroat thing. This is a family. This is a good family. And let me tell you, you can see your learning curve is like this. In this group, it's like this. You have just basically eliminated the learning curve. If you listen, you do your due diligence, and you ask questions, no matter what questions they are. How much water do I put into a lemonade? We'll get you an answer. But this is the best group I have seen on Facebook, on the internet, or anything that really gets in there and works hand in hand. You can't ask for a better man than Ben whenever you have a problem with something. He is right there. So, hey, you new guys, come on in. $27 a month, completely tax deductible. And we've got a person that will even to it help you out on your bookkeeping and your taxes and keep you straight.
I love it. I'm glad you brought that up, Lyman, because we not only are we giving away the carts tonight, it'll come with 3 months of true professional bookkeeping that one of our members is a professional at, and she is giving that away to those two members on top of it. So out of her own pocket. And I think it's awesome. I think you will too, because you'll be able to really see how good you're doing and what you're doing and where you need to make changes. Justin, Gavin, thank you for being here.
Yeah, thanks. Thanks, Ben. I was probably like a lot of you about, I started right around maybe a year after COVID, got stuck, was bored, looking around, and bought a cart out of no due diligence or nothing. Just bought a cart, read your book, Ben, but I guess I didn't get the message. Bought a cart. And then had buyer's remorse about 2 days later. And thank God your policy was explicit. And I said, okay, I'm getting a cart. Anyways, it's been a whirlwind, the best thing I ever did. I love it. But what I really love about Vendors U, and there's other stuff out there, but it's the accountability. You know, we hold each other to a higher standard. And I've been held to a higher standard because I'll put something out there and Mike Wood will slap my hand and say, nope, can't do that. And I think I'm doing the right thing, you know, because it's all new to everybody. But it's accountability and learning from others and the ups and downs, because it is up and down business, but it's a great business. And if you embrace it, you'll kick butt at it. So it's just been a good thing. And that's I'll quit my business, but I won't quit Vendors U. I really like it that much. I like hearing what I love hearing everybody's successes. To me, it's a good thing.
Thank you. All I got. Justin, I appreciate it. Ken, you free for a minute?
I think so. I started with no knowledge, and boy, did I have a lot to learn. It wasn't anybody in my family, any of my friends were doing vending. I didn't know anything. I started out with lemonade, tried to expand to different areas of different food products and just made mistakes. Then one night I came across Ben and Michael, my friend down in Georgia. It was on Sunday night shows, and I started studying Ben and his team on YouTube. I still watch the videos. And listen to Ben on Sunday nights. I became a sponge. I was teachable. If there's one thing I can tell you, You don't know it all. I don't know it all. I've been doing it for many years. Ben doesn't know it all. Michael doesn't. We know a lot, but we're all teachable. We're teachable, and we can learn new things, new tricks to make a difference. So then Ben started VU at some point. I don't know how many years ago. And immediately I signed up for the lifetime membership because I knew that this was the place I needed to be. There wasn't anything out there like it. You can go to different groups on Facebook, but I'm telling you right now, there's nothing like our group. The reason is because we're serious. If you have a question, like Lyman said, there's not a dumb question. There's not going to be a smart aleck answer. You know, we're serious. We want to help you. We want to grow also. We want to learn from the newbies that come in because they're fresh. They got new ideas that sometimes I get stuck in my, you know, rut. So VU has, I mean, changed my life, made a lot of great friends in here, but I've learned a lot and it's excelled my business. And so I'm very thankful that Ben's created this membership. I would encourage you to join and don't just kick the tires. Get in here, be serious about it, ask questions, and we got the answers for you. Somebody in here does. They have experience in everything and they've made the mistakes that you're making. They've made the mistakes I've made. And so I can't encourage you enough to really take it serious and just be teachable. Don't get in a rut where, you know, you think, okay, that won't work in my area. There's somebody in your area that's part of EU most likely, and they'll tell you different. So love you, Ben. Very thankful for your friendship over the years and everybody else that's in here too. I won't name anybody else besides Michael and Lyman and a bunch of them that I'll forget somebody out and I don't want to do that. So
I appreciate that, Ken. I love you, brother. And, you've helped me a ton over the years. Heck, you had to reteach me how to do lemons, this past summer. So, or last summer.
Yeah, I had to teach you how to do your own machine, if I remember correctly.
Yeah.
That was, I thought,
what is this thing?
That's probably not a good idea to teach men.
Thank you.
That was a memory I'll never forget.
me neither, unfortunately. Brian Pierce, go ahead, brother.
Well, joining VU for me the last 4 years has been awesome. Now, we don't do hot dogs. We do kettle corn. And we've been doing kettle corn for 12 years. The last 4 years I was in VU. I even got interviewed by Ben one time. And I got to be honest, I watched that thing a few times and I thought I was embarrassed at what I didn't know after I sat there and watched it. So I snuck into a couple of meetings, joined VU, and the first piece of advice that month gave me $1,000 in my pocket. And I'd already been doing kettle corn for 8 years. So for the bottom line, it's a lot of money. The other benefits is you learn how to do things more efficiently when you're starting to talk to other people. Hey, what worked for them, whether you're adding donuts or cotton candy or something like that. And then the process of how you're doing it. What does your booth look like? You know, are you washing your hands right? Are things going right in your booth? You sit there and talk about it. Yeah, you can get real hungry. Somebody talking about funnel cake and bologna steaks, but, you know, it's part of it. And recipes are shared. I mean, 3, 4, 5, 10 different sauces on a hot dog. I never thought you'd do that. But we have been, trying to put together, some expansion from kettle corn to some more food products. And, I feel like as soon as I'm ready to pull the trigger, I'm ready to go. I mean, just from what you learned here. So, yeah, it's well worth the $27. I mean, well, I broke even way before then. So, I mean, and I've taken that advice that I got the very first couple of months and I've doubled it. I mean, it's definitely doubled my business.
I appreciate it, Brian. You've been a big help and an asset, to many, and I'm thankful. Brian's always there, to help, in the, meetings every week and answers questions through the week for others. He is a master at kettle corn and does it and been doing it for a long time and helps many. And there's so much that applies over. So just because Brian does kettle corn, if you ask him about marketing, he knows. So because it applies to donuts too and lemonade and everything else. So thank you. Thank you, Brian. Dean and Heather, go ahead.
Hey, Ben, thank you. I want to throw a kind of different perspective. A lot of people on here have been talking about they've been around for years. This weekend is 1 year in business for us. And I found you 15, 16 months ago. All right. And I started figuring out we could do this. And I built my own cart based on your plans. Didn't look like your plans anymore, but that's where I started. And I want to speak to those people who are thinking about this and listening to all this. We would not have made it this year without Vendors United. I mean, we jumped in and you know, made all the mistakes and watched every video and still made a ton of mistakes, you know, and but we talked about those and brought them up on here, and people helped us through them. So I'd say the biggest help everybody's been is giving us hope sometimes. You know, we come in here sometimes, you've seen this, we're haggard. It was a bad day, you know, and we've seen other people do it. They go, no, we had one of those, you'll get through it, you know. And the fact that someone else comes up and says, well, yeah, but we had a good weekend, this is what happened. And we take that to heart and go, yeah, we can keep going another week. And then we have a good day, like this weekend. We had a really good weekend at a softball game and a softball tournament. And you know, it's just little things like that that keep us going. We look forward to those two calls a week. Sometimes it keeps us in business. So I want to say thank you to Ben for making this and everybody who's listening. It's worth every penny of it, and it's made a difference in this last year. You might want to add some to that, but
the one thing that, you know, that we were, I know that it was part of the pre-show and whatnot, and, you know, the word Yankee was thrown around. I am dyed in the wool Yankee, and I will tell you how things are.
We can tell it's the blue hair. We know.
I mean, you have people that will try to beat around the bush and whatnot. You may not get it the best delivery, but it's definitely from the heart. It's definitely to help. And I'm the biggest skeptic. This was not what I wanted. You know, I've said this was not what I wanted to do. And I have a ball when I go out every time. And it doesn't matter that we are dragging at the end of the day. And it doesn't matter that we've used all our energies. But at the end of the day, it is something that we like to do. And most of that is because of all of the help that we've gotten from the people in this group.
Love it. Thank y'all for sharing. I appreciate it. Jesse Rogers, go ahead.
Hey, I just want to say that it's a lonely world out there and nobody else understands what you go through as a vendor, except for these guys. And it's great to have the support. Thank you.
Thank you, Jesse. That was great. I like that. Mr. David Hirsch. Come on, David.
Hello.
Hey, David. Go ahead.
What's great about VU is everybody here has different experiences, and you can't find this kind of teaching at any college. Even Vienna Beef offers a hot dog university. This is more of a hot dog or food vendor university. But some of us teach, some of us learn, because we all have different experience. You never know what's going to happen, what help you might need, from repair jobs to increasing your sales. You're just having good friends. I have a few VM members right next door to me, and me and her always team up. But she works something Monday and Sunday, so she can't get on here. I just text her to try to get on here because the store's closed. Then Lewis lives in Albany. He met me in Kingston going to a funeral. Then he got a hot dog cart and joined VU because of his friend's funeral. Weird. That's kind of weird, but he's right. Loved joining the hot dog business, and he's only an hour and a half from me. And I was doing a Borscht Belt Fest in Ellenville, talking to this one smoothie guy. Found out, I didn't know, I just found out he's in VU, but I didn't talk to him. I just found out a couple days ago he's also in VU. Even he's technically in New Jersey, so that's too far away from me. I'm like an hour and a half north of New York City, Kingston, New York, which is technically like farm country, or was. But like I said, that $27 is worth more, like a college course, what we learn here, and you can't learn that in any college. That's it.
Well, thank you so much, David, and we love your presence here, and the unique stuff you bring to this group. I love it. I appreciate you. I'm going to grab Luis, and then I want to recap something real quick for folks, and then we're giving away two cards. Luis, go ahead.
Hi. I just want to say I've been in VU since 2021. I have a stand king. I had no experience in vending at all. What I appreciate most about VU is I'm just a weekend vendor, and so my learning curve was quite slow. So I made a lot of mistakes, but whenever I would reach out to anyone, I would get immediate response for whatever the case, be it my pipes busted because I'm in Ohio and I didn't know to put antifreeze in and putting in a new, whatever the problem is, if I need to reach out to someone, everybody just is very supportive. I feel like VU is like my parents in for vending. And I just appreciate everyone. I don't come on a whole lot, but when I do, the conversations are always, I can always learn something. I don't talk a lot during them, and I just listen, and I am going to start writing things down more frequently so that I don't forget. But I just like everyone in the group, and I just appreciate the love that's here. That's it.
I appreciate that, Luis. I thank you for sharing that. And especially pointing out the love that's here. And sometimes, you know, I have somebody message me and go, Michael Wood said this, or Mark Lawler said this, he was mean to me. And Jason Brown, I get that on everything Jason Brown says to somebody. But he means well, he's got a heart of gold. He'd give you a shirt. If you called Jason Brown and said, hey, I need you to come down here tomorrow and help me do this event, I don't know what I'm doing, he'd get on a plane and go. The guy has a big heart and will help anyone. You just got to put up with some of his rough edges. But I love him. And, so anyway, to recap real quick. So the reason I'm pushing, not just joining VU, is either upgrading to the annual, by the end of the month, and I will double that money off of any cart you purchase, in the next year. The reason I'm doing the annual, is because I have found, like I said in the beginning, that people that stay in here do way better. They make more money. They avoid a lot of learning curves, like you've heard tonight. The other thing is if you join tonight, I'm going to quadruple it. So you're going to spend $243, and I'm going to give you four times that back in a coupon that you can use over the next year or so. Okay. So I just wanted to cover that. Plus the two winners, and she's here tonight, the one of our VU members that does professional bookkeeping, and can make you more money by bookkeeping. She is here tonight, and she has donated 3 months to each person that wins a cart. And so out of her own pocket, out of her own heart, out of her own love. And I think it's fantastic. Her name is Everland. You'll see her in the stuff here. If you want to say thank you to her, but let's get on with, the giveaway. We only got 17 minutes cause I set the show up for an hour. And I like to drag stuff out. So the first one I'm going to do is the VU members. And we had not gobs of members. Cause here's the cool thing about VU is I told them on Thursday night, I said, don't compete for this cart. If you really can't use it or you don't need it, or you're in a state where you can't even use it. Cause this is a loaded up. Today I priced this cart. If you went to my site today and priced it, it's $12,048 with everything on it. Okay. This was a demo cart, that's been cooked on because I've demoed it and made videos, and, I did a little charity thing with it once. Anyway, but it's a brand new cart and it's never been registered. So, this person, I hope you're here because you're going to win this, is, and I don't know your last name because the email doesn't have your last name, but it is Lonnie from Loco for Coco. Okay. So Lonnie, you got the cart, the Cater Pro cart, next.
Thank you.
Oh, you know what, Lonnie, I want to hear from you. Are you here?
Yeah. Wow. I'm not dressed properly, so I won't turn on the camera.
You don't have to turn on any cameras.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Oh my God.
Would you care to share what you're going to do?
Yeah. So I already started doing some lemonade and ice cream a couple of times this summer under a tent, and I was looking to add to that because I know it's hard work, but I really enjoyed it and I made some money the second time. And so I really want to take the cart and use it to kind of start to a point where it's not just me out there vending. Maybe I can have more than one cart down the road, and I'm not sure if I'm going to need to depend on Vendors United to help me with this, but I'm not sure if I'm going to start off just trying to do something in a parking lot or downtown on one of the corners or what. So I just need some guidance along that. Well, I got a couple of events.
Lonnie, this is a Cater Pro loaded. So you're in North Carolina, correctly? Correct?
That's right.
Okay. So not going to probably be on the street vending with this cart. It'd be great for private events, private gigs. If you have a trailer, if you ever buy you an empty trailer, and put in a, like an awning window, like a concession trailer, but don't have anything in it. You can roll this inside of it and operate it as a full food truck. It has everything on it, from a fridge, freezer, deep fryer, commercial griddle, two commercial steam tables, and a grill. It is loaded.
Oh, thank you so much.
Absolutely. I'm looking forward to seeing what you do with it.
Me too.
thank you. So much. Thank you for being here. All right. Okay. Next. And I'm so excited about this, but I had multiples because this is where most of the I'm not even on, am I? Okay, now I'm back. Here he is. So I had, a handful of people in our VU group that said, you know what, Ben, I could actually use this cart and I can work around it and this will be, a blessing. But everybody else in non-VU members, I was going to give away a brand new, not a used, not a demoed, brand new big dog. Okay. And if you are in a state where you can have a grill, I'm going to add a grill to it for you. If you're whatever you need it built like, I'm going to build it like. Okay. And I'm going to do it quick. So I'll have it ready for you and you can pick it up in 4 to 5 days and have it. But I got tons of email responses for this. And this was the hardest year ever for me because heartfelt. And even though I asked for no stories, I got some stories. And I tried to, just breeze through it without crying or tearing up. But I want you to know that I wanted to do this. There is a guy I've never met, never spoke to, but this is the person. If they're here tonight, they will get it. If they're not, I'm going to go to the next person. But I hope they're here. It's Darren Lawson with Law Dogs. Darren Lawson, you get a big dog however you want it. Okay, it's my favorite card. I could have any card I want because we build them, right? And right outside, right behind me over here in a little metal building, I have my big dog. And I love it. And I now don't, go out every day on the street, but I do go use it for charity events and stuff like that. We helped a church youth organization recently with it. Anyway, are you here, Darren Lawson?
I am here and excited.
Holy cow. And a camera on. Had your shirt on.
That's it. I won't stand up. No.
thank you. Darren, tell us a little about what you're going to do with it. Tell us that.
Well, real fast, I have been looking for probably 3 years and trying to find something to do with my daughters and kept kicking things around. And for some reason, I don't want to cut grass with me. So we didn't do the landscape business anymore. But I found yourself on YouTube, your video with Ken Packer. Hopefully, Ken, you're here. Thank you so much for sharing everything you did with Ben. That gave me the confidence to go. And I can tell you the lemonade that we've been doing, we've only done one so far. We literally smashed it, pun intended. And your recipe, Ken, works in Delaware. We had a really good show. I did find out in Delaware that I can only do 17 events the way that I'm doing it in a tent. So I'm really hoping to use this cart to extend it, get the certification and permits to be able to do more. So looking to add a lot to the menu with this. So excited. Thank you so much.
I am happy you're here and I look forward to seeing, we can help you with that. Some of those codes up north, are illegal. And they just have to be challenged. Jason Brown's challenged them, four others. And we use the Institute for Justice to do that. But a lot of these cities and states, they have some protectionism laws or codes to protect restaurant owners. Nothing preventing a restaurant owner from getting a cart and doing what we do. We're the ones in the sun and the heat and having to pull our restaurant around on wheels. There's a lot of benefits to that, but there's nothing stopping them from doing it. So there shouldn't be any protection for them. This is, America. Anyway, we've never lost a case in 16 years ever. And we've overturned every challenge we've ever made. We have overturned the rules. So, we can help you with that as well. I look forward, Darren, for your success stories out of it.
Ready for the road trip to come see you.
I look forward to it. So if you won, all you got to do is email me, Ben at VendorsUnited.com, and just tag it or something with winner or something so that I'll catch it, because I'm probably going to have some people mad at me, because I usually do after these giveaways. And I swear, if I was a multi-bajillionaire, I'd just make carts and give them away and change lives, because it changed mine. It took me from broke and just fresh out of bankruptcy and food stamps with six kids. Well, we had five and then adopt another, but anyway, six kids. And then, and within my first week, I got a hot dog cart after buying, stealing, borrowing, from everybody, selling two kidneys and not mine, kids. And they, and then got a cart. And then 7 weeks later, I had three carts paid for by the first cart and was able to pay back a mother-in-law and everything, nothing. I never had to look back, just keep going. And so you can too. It can change your life. It is a BYOB affair. It's a bring your own business, be your own boss. You own it. You cannot put it in the garage. You cannot, and Darren, I'm not picking on you. What I'm saying is anybody, the people that fail at this is because they didn't work it. They didn't do it. They expected it to make money in their garage somehow, that it was going to just make money from their garage. And they don't work like that. You have to work it. You have to do it. VU gives you a path to get there. Doesn't mean you won't get there. There's many vendors out there that have been super successful without a VU. But the quickest path I know of is that. And I hope that if you're listening and you want to change your life, I will be glad to help you. It will make my day. It's what I live for every day. I love you. And I thank you for being here tonight. And I look forward to tomorrow night's our normal VU meeting.
8:30, everybody.
Tasha, I screwed up, Lyman. I got 6 minutes. Does anybody have a question? Because I said I'd answer any questions. Does anybody got a question they need? If they'll pop their hand up, I'll hit that little button that makes the little hand come up. I'll answer it as quick as I can. If not, I'm going to go. Go ahead, Marvin. You have to unmute.
Okay, I'm sorry.
No problem.
Ben, I want to thank you. My wife kind of nudged me along on this, joining VU. I'm just getting started into this business, and I've really learned a lot, especially last meeting we had on Thursday night about the commissaries. And I'd like to call you someday, and maybe you can help me out getting this problem figured out, because I really want to start getting that big dog out there and slinging some hot dogs.
I hope you do. I want you too, and I thank you for sharing that. Michael Wood just reminded me that if you need some just video help, we have a ton of them, a lot of them that he made. So if you can't understand it, just put it on 3x the speed, because he's from Georgia and they talk slow. And so just put it on 3x the speed, it'll sound like everybody else. But if you go to hotdogcartstore.com /help, there's a ton of videos. Most of them Michael did for us. And it will help you no matter what cart you own or what you're doing, or if you're replacing burners or whatever. It'll give you the most stuff. Salty Dogs, go ahead.
All right. Hey, thanks a lot, man. Really, thank you. I joined the Mafia and I joined United, and I got me a cart and I started selling hot dogs out here on the Oregon coast. I'm here to tell you this is more fun than I've had in a long time, and I'm doing it sober. My question is, I'm steaming my dogs. After I steam them, I grill them a little bit, cut them down the middle. Then I put them on a nice bun, and then I dress them out. It seems like a lot of work. Does anybody else dress their dogs with relish and onions and mustard and sauerkraut, or do you let the customer do it? Thank you, Ben, for everything.
All right. You asked basically, do you let them put on their condiments? Okay. Here's some states don't allow you to. And even if they don't allow you to, or do allow you to, I have done it. I've let customers, and I always, even if they don't allow it, I still have a little table where they can squirt ketchup or squirt mustard or mayonnaise, whatever, relish. But I like dressing it, because I don't know about you. Have you ever had just a regular ham sandwich? Probably going to say yes. You've had a regular ham sandwich. I swear to you, and you have to agree with me on this, or you're going to make me look dumb. Ham sandwiches that are made by somebody else always taste better. It's like when my mom used to make my peanut butter and jelly sandwich, or peanut butter and honey sandwich. It always tasted better when she made it.
Agreed.
And then when I make it, I don't know why that is. It's something about the love they put into it. So I would make the stuff, even if it slows you down. Yeah. I would just embrace it that people are in line, and they're in line so they can eat, and give them the best experience. So if you can make it for them, that's the best way.
Thank you, Ben.
Absolutely. Thank you for the question. Lefty, go ahead.
Good evening, everyone. It was fun to watch. Congratulations on winning those carts. That is awesome. My question is to you. I think I might have missed a video, but I had a town tell me that I needed permission from restaurants that are within a mile radius from me if I decide to open up a stand in a spot with permission. I could have sworn that I might have heard it somewhere that that's not a mandated issue with if I actually brought it to their attention. But it was just weird to me that they asked me that I needed permission to get from two restaurants that happen to be a mile from me. Guess just what? To sell hot dogs.
You're going to love this.
Yes, sir. So
if, as long as you're in America and the part of America that still has the Constitution and stuff, and I'm being facetious, but you know, you get my point, Lefty. If you're in the U.S., we have a Constitution that includes a Bill of Rights. In the Bill of Rights is the right to work bill. Okay. In that right to work covers all this. Point is a city, until they're challenged, they will make some protectionist laws and codes to protect their buddies, their cronies who helped them get elected. Some of them are the ones that are on the board that own, you know, the seven chains of Pizza Hut or whatever. So my I will tell you this personal experience. I lived in the Outer Banks, and my daughter was vending. This is in North Carolina. My daughter was vending. I was vending. And then there was a few other vendors in town. One of them called me and said, Ben, you know, I can't be within 1,000 feet of another restaurant. I said, what? And I've never been told that. And he goes, yeah, I can't be. And so I called the county and I checked, and they told me, yep, nothing they could do about it. They were just stuck on that. And I said, okay. And so I contacted IJ, and IJ is the Institute for Justice. If you want to look that up, it's free service. And they, sent them a letter. The city or the county of Dare County, North Carolina, said, nope, we'll just go to court. Well, right before court, they said, oh, we didn't realize we were violating his constitutional rights. And it went away, and they reversed it. Miami tried this years and years ago as part of that federal suit, and they ended up having to pay all the active vendors money back for lost money. So lost money. So yes, you definitely have it. We have a letter inside of VU that you can use from the Institute for Justice that Jason Brown got for us when his city told him he wasn't allowed to vend in the city because they have restaurants and that would create competition for the restaurants. Anyway, check that out. And you can always email me these other questions. I'm gonna do two more and then we got to go.
Thank you.
Thomas, go ahead.
Hey, Ben, appreciate you doing what you do. I started watching your videos about 2 months ago, and I just started, got on Vendors United Friday. Still trying to figure out the system there, but while I got you on here, is lemonade fall under agriculture in Virginia, or do I just need to keep looking through VU to find it?
Email me and I'll find out for you, but I don't remember off the top of my head. And we had a vendor in there that was in VU for years, but he passed away this past year, and I don't remember if that's agriculture. He also did hot dogs, so he would have had to do the health department route too, but I
want to do both, but I'm going to start with the lemonade.
Yeah, the lemonade's a great way to start, but I can find it for you real quick because I'll have it somewhere. Just email me, BennettVendorsUnited.com, and I'll get you the information.
All right, thank you, Ben.
Absolutely. Thanks for being here. Jay Norris, go ahead, brother.
How you doing, Ben?
Doing good, brother.
My question is, I am trying to get started in the vending business, just starting out, actually, getting things figured out as far as what I need to do in my the town that I live in and so forth. I live just outside of Boston, and I was on the city's website looking at what they what they require for street vendors, and one of their rules is that a vendor must be prepared to move every 5 minutes. That doesn't seem legal to me.
No, it's not. It's not legal. We've challenged that in Atlanta, in Cedar Key, Florida, and in Miami-Dade County in Miami, Florida, and we won all those cases. So absolutely illegal. We have a letter for that too in the group, and you can go into the files section. If you need help, email me. I'll find it for you and get it to you.
Great. Thank you so much, Ben.
Absolutely. Thanks for being here. All right. I know I said bye earlier. I love you. I want the best for you. Go out there and make some money. Even if you don't join VU, I'll still help you. I help as many people as I can. Thank you for being here. Congratulations to the winners. And I'll see you, VU members, tomorrow night. Bye.
Good night, Ben.
Good night.
Good night, everyone.